Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is Dhruv, we are from Plus Drive. Hope you guys are doing great and absolutely fine. So today we are going to talk about the Ford EcoSport BS6 variant which you see in front of me. So we are going to talk about everything, what are the changes in price and all, the BS6 variant, what it is offering you. And also before to provide you any information on the car, first thing I would like to thank Satyam Ford in Thane for allowing me to review the vehicle. You can directly contact them if you want to have any inquiry regarding mileage or any Ford EcoSport Aspire or Endeavor. If you want to know anything, please feel free to contact them between 10 a.m. to 8 p.m. Now getting back to the car, the Ford EcoSport, the BS6 variant is priced from 8.4 lakh to rupees 11.58 lakh ex-showroom Delhi. It is offered in 4 variants which you can see on your screen. Now talking about the keys, you get the same keys, smart keys over here with silver insert, black piano finish. You get lock and unlock button. When you unlock the car, the ORVMs automatically open, and when you lock it again, it will close itself by automatically. Now getting back to the car, you won't see much changes in the car, no cosmetic updates and all. It is a BS6 variant, what you see, BS6 compliant engine. Getting back to the headlamp over here, you get a projector headlamp, LED DRLs in the front, then a high beam plum is halogen. You over here, you're getting that. On the lower side, you get the fog lamp and you also get a turn indicators. This is the front towing hook. Then talking about the grill, you get chrome insert and some matte black inserts inside the grill, so this looks more premium than a Ford logo in between. So just a regular, and like the previous EcoSport you're getting over here. On the lower side, you get the skid plates, and the lower bumper is in the body color only. Only the skid plates you're getting in gray inserts, so that looks good with the combination of white color. Now guys, talking about the main thing regarding the pricing, when you compare to BS4 and this BS6, the price is hiked by 13,000 rupees on every model, which I'm going to share in the description also. Please go and see that. Now talking about the tire size and specification over here, you get a R16-inch alloy wheels on this, so which looks premium. In the front you get the disc brake, and in the rear you get the drum brake. And also you don't get any wheel cladding, but on the door you get a cladding for the safety purpose, you can say. But this looks good, the black insert cladding. And the ORVMs, they are electronically adjustable and retractable. You get a body color half ORVMs, and on the lower side you get black insert. Then the turn indicators are on the ORVM itself, not on fenders. On the door handle, you don't get any chrome insert or a passive keyless entry button, which you can say a request button, just a simple door handle in body color. Again over here, the 16-inch alloy wheel. You get a nice alloy wheel, drum brakes at the back. Then you get a roof rails over here, which are again in silver inserts, and a sunroof. This car gets sunroof because this is the petrol top end variant, is automatic transmission, but I'll be giving you every detail for all the variants. The P pillar is in black insert, that looks again to gives a sporty feel. Then a C pillar in black piano finish, the B pillar is in matte black. So lot of blacks are going on over here. If I talk about the rear profile, again the same what the previous EcoSport had. You get a titanium badging on the lower side, then you get a handle lock to open the tailgate, which is in chrome insert. You get a magnetic opening over here under the handlebar. Then on the left side you get a tail lamp. You don't get any LED inserts. You get a conventional tail lamp, EcoSport badging on the lower side in chrome insert, and a Ford badging just above that. Spare wheel, again full size alloy wheel you're getting, 16 inch. Then on the lower bumper you get the parking sensors and reflectors. These parking sensors are standard across all the variants from base to top end variant. You get the HD reverse parking sensor, the camera just above the number plate, you can say. Then again the reflectors on the other side as well. So in the rear you get the dual tone bumper, which is in black insert, and in the front you only get a single tone, which is white color. Talking about the suspension system of the car, in the front EcoSport is provided with independent McPherson strut with coil spring and anti-roll bar, and in the rear semi-independent twist beam with twin gas and oil fill shock absorber, for which the ride quality is superb on this vehicle. And also guys, regarding the dimension, it will be on your screen. You can see the dimension, it has got a nice, what you can say, a nice ground clearance. So because there will be no problem on the huge speed bumps or speed breakers and even the potholes, that would be great. And this EcoSport makes a very nice ride quality. The build quality is very great on this car, so not much cosmetic updates if you see it from the exterior. So now if I talk about some features on the EcoSport over here, the top end variant, you get automatic climate control, auto projector headlamps and cruise control. It also gets a push start stop button, rain sensing wipers and a sunroof. Moreover, you also get a paddle shifters in case you if you have taken the automatic transmission, which you see in front of me, and a lot of safety features like ABS with EBD, side impact beam, crash sensors, front impact beams. Then you get child safety locks and Then dual front airbag, seat belt reminder. A lot of safety features are coming with the Ford EcoSport, and build quality is great. So that is why it's a very nice sub 4 meter compact SUV. Now talking about the interiors, lock and unlock button, tweeters, door, the handlebars are in aluminium finish. These are the window controls and your ORVM controls. Soft padded, you get an armrest, again the premium quality. Then you get a silver insert piano finish plating just on the gram handlebar. So this looks great. And also on the lower side, speaker system, 1 liter bottle storage and umbrella storage over here. So everything is very, you know, you can say neatly organized, placed everything. So this was the door trim in beige and black color. Again, the interior black and beige color, the fabric upholstery. I would be happy if I get a leather premium upholstery on this thing. But no, this is a fabric upholstery. According to the price segment, it is calculated. Then these are the height adjustable seats. You can adjust it from here, and also reclining option, which is manually. Now I'll just sit inside the car and show you everything from inside the car regarding the comfort, even the knee room and all. So as I'm inside over here, guys, so I'm quite comfortable. The seat has very nice lumbar support, and also you get a nice under thigh support. I'm happy with the seat, what the comfort is provided to me in this price segment. Talking about the instrument cluster, you get analog tachometer on the left, speedometer on the right. Then also you get a MID display in the between, which will show you vehicle settings, distance to empty, and lot of vehicle features it will show you. Then talking about the steering wheel, not a flat bottom steering wheel, you get cruise controls over here. And also steering mounting controls, around that you get a silver insert. So it feels very premium. The steering wheel feels premium, but I would be happy if this gets a flat bottom steering wheel just like Tata Nexon. Then steering wheel is adjustable, guys, both for rake and reach. This is a telescopic steering wheel. On the left side you get your wiper controls, and on the right side you'll get your light controls and your turn indicator controls. The light control is just above your right knee. You also get a paddle shifter. As you remember, I told you, if it take your automatic transmission, you get a paddle shifting on this variant. Then around the AC vents, it is blacked out, no chrome or no body color, nothing like that, anything insert. The dashboard is really big and the plastic quality is good. This is a quarter glass. The plastic quality is very good. I mean, Ford has always given you a nice plastic quality in every car. On the passenger side, you get a vanity mirror plus vanity light, and not on the driver side. Then this is a sunshade holder on the top. You get a Bluetooth receiver just ahead of that. Then this is a sunroof opening button. I'll just show you. Yeah, over here the sunroof buttons are available. Then the auto dimming ORVMs. This is not manually. So again, a premium feature. According to the safety wise, talking about the center console, you get a nice 7-inch infotainment touchscreen HD screen over here. Engine start stop button also you get around that, the chrome insert. So this is the instrument cluster. Yes, so you get the MID display in the between, analog tachometer on the left, speedometer on the right, fuel gauge on the bottom side. So this infotainment supports Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, AUX, USB, Bluetooth. Around that you get silver insert, which gives you a premium finish, and the quality feels very slush and rich, and the screen doesn't lag. It has a very nice response, you can say, and the sound quality in this car is superb. I mean, they have upgraded it to the infotainment, if I talk about the infotainment part. So the screen size is same to the previous variant. On the lower side you get your controls for the infotainment screen, as well as this is a touch screen. So the screen is just booted up, that's why it is getting a bit lag. But the controls are on the lower side. Then around the AC vents, you get silver insert, what you were getting over here, the piano finish insert around the door trim. You also get around the AC vents. The hazard button is in the between. So, yes, you can see the navigation. So screen lags, but only a bit. I mean, not much. Then on the lower side, you get a automatic climate control as well over here. Around that, you get a chrome insert buttons. So the quality is good. They provided a nice quality if you compare it to the BS4 or the previous generation or a variant. So automatic climate control again, which really cools the cabin really fast. Then this is the traction TCS off button. Two USB ports over here which are illuminated. Then 12V charging socket over here, and ahead of that you get a nice storage to keep your phone or anything, wallet like that. Talking about the transmission, you get a nice gear knob. You get leather stitch gear knob. Under that you get the PRNDS. This is the automatic transmission. So nothing like chrome insert or a black piano finish around the gear knob, but around the handbrake you get a leather upholstery, and the tip of the handbrake is in aluminium finish. Two cup holders and one can holder. Talking about the armrest, it is leather stitched, so the quality feels really great. And this is a very deep glove box, I mean armrest storage compartment, you can see. So overall the cabin feels, you know, premium. The quality and materials are used premium. The fabric upholstery is great, and even this grab handlebar on the dashboard, which is in black piano finish. Talking about the glove box compartment, it is good. I mean, I would be happy it would be even bigger in size, and that is a cool glove box compartment. So everything inside the car feels really, you know, what you can say, premium. Then these are the controls on the left side for the infotainment, and for the on the right side it is for the MID display in the instrument cluster with the controls which you see on the steering wheel. So everything, as I said again and again, this is a nice car in this price segment. I mean, just to give it a thought. And also guys, one thing I would like to add on over here, the Ford Pass feature, what does it do? It allows you more connectivity between your Ford vehicles and your smartphone, and members who own the Ford vehicles equipped with Sync Connect can use the Ford Pass to access vehicle. And also features such as remote start, lock and unlock, fuel, oil and battery levels, and the tire pressure reading. So everything will be shown on the app itself, the Ford Pass feature. So that was a sunroof I had opened for you. Just one press it will open full and one press it will close full. The cabin lights are conventional. The Ford Pass feature is really good on this vehicle, so which allows you to, you know, on the smartphone only you can see everything about the vehicle. So that is a great thing guys, and this is about the front cabin. Now let us just jump into the rear cabin and see what are the comfort and space provided you at the rear cabin. So yes guys, so as I'm in the rear over here, so first thing, same beige and black interior on the door trim and in the rear cabin. So over here, aluminium finish handlebar, window controls are on the bottom side, soft padded armrest. You get a gray insert piano finish on the grab handlebar, 1 liter bottle storage and a speaker system. I would be happy if there was a more, you know, decent storage on the doors. You get a child safety locks at the rear doors. Then these are the cabin. The rear cabin, you get an adjustable headrest, and the fabric upholstery is good, same as the front. The comfort looks good, and these are huge seats, so the under thigh support would be very great. So only two headrests for the rear passenger, no middle headrest for the middle passenger, you can say. You get an armrest with two cup holders. So I'll just sit inside and show you everything. So one thing I really liked over here, you get a 12V charging socket. This was there in the previous variant, I know that, but this is a nice feature rather than to have it in the between the wires and all will come in your legs. So this is a nice thing, again a nice feature I could say. You get a nice headroom, and I really like the under thigh support on this vehicle. You can see the knee room, the seats are maximum at the back. I am 5'8", so quite comfortable. Seat pockets are available on both the sides. Then you don't get any 12V charging socket over here. It was given on the right side of the passenger, just behind the driver side. So this is a nice thing. I mean, it would be more convenient in simple language. The seats are quite comfortable. They are comfortable. You get a nice under thigh support. You can see over here, I mean, such a big under thigh support, I'm quite comfortable. The seats have nice reclining angle. Single armrest available with two cup holders over here. The quality is good of the cup holders and all. You don't get any headrest in between. Then the cabin lights for rear cabin, they are available, and seats are, and the door trim and all, quality is used nice if you compare it to the front. I mean, same quality, not a cheap one. The materials and quality is good. They feel absolutely premium. So this is the cabin view of front. So the car is spacious. The car feels very airy because of these beige seat colors. The hump is on the lower side, so the middle passenger can sit very easily. Then you get a quarter glass at the rear as well. Then the parcel tray. Now this is about the rear cabin. It is spacious. I mean, it feels very roomy again over here. So this is all about the rear interiors of the car and exteriors of the car. Now two last thing remaining is the boot space and what you call the engine compartment. So talking about the boot space, so Ford EcoSport provides you first of all the hydraulic studs to open such a heavy tailgate. Then you get a nice you can say insulation done for the tailgate itself. Okay, and also rear defoggers and everything is available, the parcel tray. So the EcoSport provides you 352 liters of boot space. So that is a nice thing. And the rear seats are split into 60-40. They are partially divided. You get a light to access the boots in the night time for better visibility. Nothing over here. You get a toolkit only because the spare wheel is on the exterior side. You get some space on the right side as well as on the left side. So 352 liters of boot space, that is a decent amount of boot space on a compact SUV. I must say that is a good thing, a big boot space available in this car. So this is all about the boot space. Now let us just talk about the engine compartment. But before that, I'll talk about the BS6 mileage. Again over here, the Ford EcoSport diesel is 23.0 kmpl, Ford EcoSport petrol is 18.1 kmpl, and the EcoSport automatic transmission, that is 14.8 kmpl, and these are according to the ARAI mileage that is claimed by the company. So this is about the, what you can say, mileage. Now if I talk about regarding the engine, so it is offered with a choice of two BS6 compliant engine. One is 1.5 liter petrol, which creates 122 PS and 149 Nm of peak torque, and a 1.5 liter diesel unit, which creates 100 PS and 215 Nm of peak torque, while the petrol engine continues to be offered with a 5-speed manual or a 6-speed automatic gearbox. 1.5 liter diesel only gets a 5-speed manual transmission, no automatic transmission. And also guys, the Ford has discontinued the 1-liter EcoBoost engine. That is a bit sad part, but this is all about the engine part. Regarding the mileage, insulation is done under the hood to decrease the engine noise into the cabin. So this is all about the exterior, interior and everything on this car. And the last thing, the car rivals with Maruti Suzuki Vitara, Brezza, Tata Nexon, Honda WRV, Hyundai Venue, Mahindra TUV300, Mahindra XUV300. So this was all about the vehicle. The number is on your screen. You can check it out and call Satyam Ford if you have any query regarding this car or anything. So bye guys, take care, see you next time, and subscribe to the channel guys. Take care, bye.